the office of Isaac and Greek, and his name is Muhammad ibn Abdullah Hadid Suleiman. He was born in the year 1116 and died in the year 1206. He was raised in a religious family and learned from early on to memorize the Quran at the age of 10, studied Tafsir and Hadith and stuff in the religious sciences, specializing in the books of Shaykh Islam and Muslimian students. He traveled to various countries, including Mecca and Medina, seeking knowledge. He has written many books, the most important of them is Tafsir al-Tawhid, and some of the other well-known books, such as the major theme, the fundamentals of faith, the Usul al-Salat and Qawaid al-Arba, and the Usul al-Sitta. Some of these books that we have studied, including this essay, and the Sharif al-La'i rahimahullah. As for the fundamentals of his da'wah, we said that they are claiming to Tawhid and warning against shirk, strictly following the Quran and Sunnah and the Salaf al-Sali, the righteous predecessors, meaning the Sahaba, and those who followed their way, avoiding the takfir, declaring Muslims to be out of Islam, and avoiding taking anyone's life except in accordance with what the Sharia allows. The first of his lesson power is that among them, among them, is the establishment of the Islamic State, the Arabian Peninsula, the correction, the interpretation of the Islamic Aqidah, extending the effect of his power outside of the Arabian Peninsula, establishment of the scholarly movement, free from Taqlid al-Ama, blind following, that is still following the evidences of Quran and Sunnah, and activating a movement of authoring and publishing Islamic books, rahimahullah. The second question mentioned a hadith showing the blessings of La ilaha illallah, and we have mentioned a number of hadiths from among them. This is the hadith of Mu'adh ibn Jabal, where the Prophet asked him, do you know the rights of Allah with a servant and the rights of the servant of Allah? The rights of Allah with a servant is that they worship him alone and do not associate anything with him. This shows the importance of La ilaha illallah, of worshipping Allah alone, which is the most important right that Allah has over the servant. And likewise, the hadith of Ibn Abbas, when Mu'adh was sent to Yemen, who was ordered by the Prophet, his heart is full with the prayer of Tawheed, and the hadith of Ibadah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a new person to paradise. No matter what their deeds are, if they have testified to these five matters, the first of them is that nothing deserves to worship except Allah alone. Question number three, define shuruq linguistically and technically. The linguistic meaning of shuruq is that first, shuruq is the plural of shark. And the shark means Al-alama, yani ma, or a sign of something. A ma, or a sign of something. But here, what we mean by shirk, we mean that which every responsible person is required to know and act in accordance with. We mean it is a condition for one tawheed to be accepted. This is what we mean by shirk here, these things which are a condition for one shahada to be accepted. This is enough that the person must know it and act in accordance with it in order for a person to be a Labihra Tawheed. We accept the first shirk or condition of La ilaha illallah. The first shirk that we have mentioned this morning is Ala ilm bima'naha. Yani know the meaning of the statement of La ilaha illallah and know its meaning, what it includes of nafi and ithbat, of negation and affirmation, meaning what it negates? It negates La ilaha, negates worship to other than Allah. That is nothing which deserves to be worshipped. And it negates worship to everything other than Allah. And illallah is affirmation, it affirms worship for Allah alone. So the statement of La ilaha illallah, we must know that it negates worship to other than Allah and affirms it for Him alone. Question number 5 mentioned with Ali, from evidence for this shirk or condition from the Qur'an or from the Sunnah. The evidence is from the Qur'an and Sunnah many, from amongst that which Imam Muhammad Abdul Wahhab has mentioned, is the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَعَلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَصَرْكُمْ لِذَنْبِكَ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ. Know that He, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that nothing deserves the worship except Him. And then He forgiveness for the sins and for the believers, men and women. And the Sunnah, the Hadith of Uthman ibn Affan, radiyallahu anhu, Qurb al Muslim, whoever dies, while he knows that nothing deserves to worship except Allah, then he will enter the paradise. Question number 6, what is the hukm الاصل المؤمن المؤمن لا اله الا الله. يعني اذا يمكن ثاني المؤمن لا اله الا الله اذا الله اورد الموت ان ذات الباب عائق اورد في مصنوعه يصير كمان نوع التوحيد لله. And the ruling concern of the house is that it is obligatory on every individual. It is called Ayn for every human being. Nobody is free from this responsibility, no matter who they may be. Question number 7 mentioned some of the ways to come to know that La ilaha illallah is a fact. The Shaykh Abd al-Rahman al-Sa'di has mentioned a number of ways that can be followed, a number of paths that a person may travel. To know that La ilaha illallah is a fact, from amongst them is reflecting upon the name and characteristics of Allah and his actions which indicate his perfection and greatness and glory. The second of them is to seek the knowledge and to know, to realize and to recognize that Allah is alone in his creation and controlling the universe, and therefore it is only right and logical that he should be alone in his rightful relationship. Number 3, it is the knowledge that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is alone in being the one who gives the bounties and favors, which we see openly, outwardly and inwardly, which we don't see. And also the knowledge of the characteristics of the idols that are worshipped besides Allah, and knowing and realizing that all of them are imperfect in every aspect that we might consider. And this also will help us to realize that Allah alone deserves to be worshipped. Likewise, the fact that there is agreement amongst the revealed books that Allah has sent to the prophets and messengers on this point, that Allah alone deserves to be worshipped. And likewise, there is agreement amongst the chosen of Allah, whether from amongst the prophets or the messengers, or the ulama of Rabbaniyun, the righteous scholars who act in accordance with the correct knowledge that they teach. There is agreement amongst them, all testifying to the fact that Allah alone deserves to be worshipped. Question number 8 mentions some of the points that may be derived from this verse, and the verse, فَعْلَمْ أَنْهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. Know that nothing deserves to worship except Allah. The third point that may be derived from it is the obligation of knowing the meaning of La ilaha illallah, and that is to include the affirmation and negation. And the second point is that the command of Allah to the Prophet to seek forgiveness for the believing men and the believing women, it is inclusive of the sinful Muslims, that they are also included in the command to seek forgiveness for them. And this is the proof that they remain Islam and that they are not out of Islam. Number 9 mentioned some of the points that may be derived from the hadith of Jabir, that will meet Allah without worshiping anything along with him, but into the paradise. The first point is that in this hadith is the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that whoever dies on Tawheed, they enter the paradise. And this shows the importance of Tawheed and keeping it pure and free from any defect. And the second of them is that the person who commits a major sin does not go outside of that which is called Iman. Though the one who commits sin, he is a fascist due to his sin, that is a believer due to his Iman. He doesn't go out of Islam. He is a mu'min to the extent that he has some Iman, and he is a fascist to the extent that he commits sin. This is the end of what we can mention. If there are any questions or comments, or correction, then we'll take them now. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. If you have any questions, you can ask them now. I'm not really clear on exactly what the question